Hello?
Is that Frank?
Yes.
Hiya, Frank. This is Jimmy Hoffa.
Yeah, yeah.
Glad to meet you.
Well, glad to meet you, too.
Even if it's over the phone. I heard you paint houses.
Yes, sir, I do. I do, and I also do my own carpentry.
Oh, I'm glad to hear that.
I understand you're a brother of mine.
Yes, sir. Local 107 since 1947.
Our friend speaks very highly of you.
Well, thank you.
He's not an easy man to please.
Well, I do my best.
Well, you know, there's a situation going on.
Nowadays, young people, they don't know who Jimmy Hoffa was. They don't have a clue. I mean, maybe they know that he disappeared or something, but that's about it. But back then, there wasn't nobody in this country who didn't know who Jimmy Hoffa was.
God bless, Jimmy. Oh. Everything you've done, you're a real gentleman.
That's good.
In the 50s, he was as big as Elvis. In the 60s, he was like the Beatles. And next to the president, he was like the most powerful man in the country, bar none.
If you got it, a truck brought it to you. If you got your food, your clothing, your medicine, if you got fuel for your homes, fuel for your industries, a truck brought it to you. The day our trucks stop, America stops.
Well, you know, there's a situation going on now, Frank, that needs to be attended to.
You know, they're trying to tear the union apart. Big business and the government
working together, trying to pull us down.
Big business is on the attack. They're coming hard, and they're coming fast. Big business and the government are trying to sow the seeds of dissent among our ranks at a time when we need unity. We need solidarity. I want to write it in the sky. Solidarity. Solidarity. Solidarity.
You wanna be a part of this fight?
Yes, I do, sir.
Would you like to be a part of this history?
Yes, I would. Whatever you need me to do, I'm available.
Can you come to Chicago tomorrow?
Yes, I can,
sir.
All right, then. See you then.
He likes the thought, don't he?
Yeah. Thought I was talking to General Patton.